I've attended a preview performance of The Picture of Dorian Gray with Sarah Snook, because obviously I couldn't wait any longer to see this highly anticipated show. If you're considering going because you love Sarah as Shiv in Succession, then this is probably the best show that you can see on the West End right now. But if you were going because you love Oscar Wilde and the novel, then there are a few things that you should consider. I'm on a mission to see 52 shows this year, which means one show a week, and I document my journey here where I share reviews and my impressions of the plays that I see. So if you like this video and you like my channel, help me get to 1,000 subscribers by subscribing and liking this video. This production has come to the West End from Sydney, where it premiered in 2020. As you might be familiar, The Picture of Dorian Gray is a novel adapted for stage and directed by Kip Williams. And what is so special about this production is that it's a one-actor show, which means that one person gets to perform 26 characters in one night, no intervals. Not only that, this production also introduces a very unique way of using camera work and projections of that camera work, and you really witness the play coming together and the actor going through this process. This production has a limited season on the West End for 14 weeks only, and it will take us all the way until mid-May, so you can go and see it until then. And beware that also tickets are a little bit on the pricier side, but let me tell you about that a little bit later in the video. It is impossible to talk about this show without firstly talking about Sarah Snook. Sarah Snook is one of the hottest actors in the world right now due to her popularity with the show Succession and an amazing role that she portrayed of Shiv Roy, which she has been awarded for multiple times throughout all seasons. And this production is probably one of the best that she can showcase her artistry, because there's a lot of camera work and she needs to interact with the camera a lot in the way that you would interact if you're filming a TV show or a movie or just doing any kind of screen acting, because there are such subtle moments of facial expressions, of looks, of just tiny smirks and things like that that make a whole difference to how a whole situation is interpreted. And Sarah, obviously being so accomplished and established within the screen acting, marrying that with her acting skills for theater, it is just something that you have to witness. It is unlike anything that I have seen before. So 10 out of 10 for Sarah. Now moving on to the production. This production is very unique and it's pushing the boundaries of what's considered traditional theater. And this is something that could appeal to certain theater goers, but also I can imagine that this is something that maybe some other theater goers might like less. One thing that you need to take into consideration is there are quite a few cameras on stage that are following Sarah around, even if she's changing or even if something else is happening. Like, it is kind of on purpose and shown to you on these kind of panels. There are like four panels that are on the stage. A lot of the time you will catch yourself actually looking at those panels, not necessarily even seeing Sarah in some instances, because she's in upstage right corner and you actually can't see it because of the panels that are blocking your view. So the production relies quite a lot on that visual effect, and it really brings art of movie making to the theater, which is incredible. Some scenes literally look like cinematography. It is all very carefully curated to portray a certain mood and to showcase certain angles, so it is really brilliant. And I think it's almost movie making meets theater and meets this amazing story that everyone loves. So I think from the production perspective, you just need to go with an open mind in terms of this not being something that you would normally expect. There's a lot of moments where there's also a little bit of a green screen type of thing, where the other characters that were portrayed by Sarah are kind of filmed in advance, but it just all works very well together. The Picture of Dorian Gray is a really popular novel by Oscar Wilde, and everyone who has read it has a special place in their heart for this novel, and I'm one of those people. And I think it is all about the way that Oscar Wilde writes. There's something poetic about even those ironic and grim moments in the book. And as with every novel to stage adaptation, there are certain elements that just don't make the cut. Overall, the way that this play is set, I think it adds another layer of more modern storyline, which kind of also is helpful helped by the way that there's a lot of cameras around and it is possible to use certain filters on the cameras and really portray certain things that are so familiar to the 21st century, making this story even more modern and closer to the younger audiences and just like audiences of today. And I think that's what this play excels in, just bringing the modern life and modern references to this well-established and much-loved novel. On to more practical things, I go to theater quite a lot, and to be honest, this is one of the more expensive plays that I paid a ticket for. I went for a £75 ticket, and this is kind of like the second or third cheapest option. The cheapest tickets are about £40 to £50, and they are all the way up at the balcony, and this is a theater that has 4 levels, I believe. You're really high up if you go for that ticket, and my biggest concern was if I was to go for that ticket is that I wouldn't be able to see everything that I needed to see because of the way that just this visual performance is set out to be. If you get a seat and if you have something that's obstructing your view at the top, I don't think you would enjoy it as much because the play relies quite a lot on those visual elements. So I would say that is one thing that I would pay attention to. Maybe spend a little bit more money and enjoy a better view if that is possible. But you can also play lottery tickets and that way go and see it for about £30. My overall impressions are that this is a play that was very well worth seeing. I think Sarah was amazing. I think that the production was so refreshing and new, and I'm really glad that I went to see it. And I actually think that it's justified for the ticket to be £75. However, when it comes to this production delivering to my love for Oscar Wilde's novel, I feel that maybe I was left a little bit of kind of just wanted a little bit more, because the production has a lot of humorous elements, but I also like that more subtle way of just pensive thinking about life, and that's something that I really liked in the book, and maybe I didn't really feel like the play delivered in that sense. Overall, I do think this is a really, really, really strong show, and from the point of acting, it is something that definitely shouldn't be missed, and you need to go and see if you really appreciate acting as an art form. If you're looking for some additional recommendations of what to see in London, then check out this video where I'm talking about 5 shows that I've seen last year that you can still see in 2024.